get ready to go. We're glad that you're all here, so now it's time to start the show. We're not in school, but we can still pretend by making music until this ends. We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hey, Falcons! It's Mrs. Dundor, and I hope you had a really good week. We're here to make music with our Falcon friends again, and we've got some great stuff planned for you this week. There's a new song with Mr. B. There's new rhythms to read and play with me. There's some awesome songs to listen to with Mrs. Castle, and a great activity with Mr. Small at the end. So, let's be done with all the talking, and let's make some music.
Hey Falcons, Mr. B here. We're gonna learn a song today that's not from America, it's actually from a different country. Although, if you speak English here, let me get my globe for a second. We're gonna take a little trip around the world here. Here we are, well, actually it's a globe, but here we are. We're gonna cross the Atlantic and go to a country over in Europe. A country right next to England, if I can find it right there, Ireland. Now, about a month ago we had a holiday, St. Patrick's Day, and there's a song from Ireland I'd like to teach you today. It's called Michael Finnegan. It goes like this. Let me grab my ukulele. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. Listen to one more time. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. Now, before we learn the words of the song, I want to teach you a little pattern. It's going to involve your hands, so watch closely. We're going to do a pat, and a pat, and a cross, and a cross, and a snap, and two claps. Watch that again. It's going to go pat, pat, cross, cross, snap, snap, clap, clap. A little bit tricky. Watch again. Pat, pat, cross, cross, snap, snap, clap, clap. Do it with me this time. Ready? Pat, pat, cross, cross, snap, snap, clap, clap. Can you do it two times in a row? Good luck. Pat, pat, cross, cross, snap, snap, clap, clap, pat, pat, cross, cross, snap, snap, clap, clap. Can you just keep doing it? Don't stop. Ready? Pat, pat, cross, cross, snap, snap, clap, clap. Pat, pat, cross, cross, snap, snap. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. Were you able to keep up? Try it again. We'll do it a little bit faster this time. Ready? Watch. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. One more time, how about just a little bit faster? Try to keep up. If you're holding your iPad or tablet, probably put that down. I don't know how you're doing this. Ready? Here we go. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. Nice job. This time, I'm going to actually sing it. I want you to echo me back this time, okay? Do a little phrase by phrase. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Thank you. we go. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan began again. Try the whole song. I'll sing it once, then it's your turn. Here we go. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan began again. Great. Let's sing it together this time. Ready? Here we go. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan began again. Now that you know how to sing it, can you sing it and do the pattern with me at the same time? Here we go. Let's put it all together. Ready? There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan began again. Great job, guys. Thanks for singing along. We'll see you next time.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hey, Falcons. Are you ready to read some music? Make sure you grab the music notation paper that you used during last week's episode. Don't forget a pencil. If you can't find the paper or you want a new one, just go ahead and look in the resources folder called Music Reading with Mrs. Dundor. You can print a new one there. All right, here's this week's melody. This week, we're going to learn how to read notes below the staff. If you already know how to do this, go ahead, pause the video and write down your answers. But if you need a refresher, keep on watching before you pause. For notes that go above or below the staff, the rules of Every Good Boy Does Fine and Face do not apply. Instead, we need to take a look at the musical alphabet. Remember, when moving from one line to the very next space, that is one step. Or vice versa, when moving from one space to the very next line, that is also one step. Here's our mystery note. We need to figure out what it is. There are three steps to solving this. One, what is a note we already know that is close to the mystery note? This is a note that we already know. This is letter E. So I went ahead and circled letter E over here. Two, to get from letter E to the mystery note, do we need to go up or down? If you said down, you are correct. You can see that the mystery note is below letter E. Three, how many steps do we have to move from letter E to the mystery note? We are going from a line to the very next space, so we only have to move one step. You can see here, we move one step down from E. So what is our mystery note? That's right, it's letter D. Here is another note that is below the staff. Pause the video and try to figure this one out on your own. If you said letter C, you're correct. This time we had to go down two steps from letter E. One, two. Now that we've reviewed how to identify notes below the staff, pause the video and write down your answers for this week's melody. Here are your answers for this week's melody. How did you do? Pause the video to check your work. Now it's time to play. This week, I'm going to use a plastic plate and a pen as my instrument. I could just tap the pen on the plate, and there's my instrument. So go grab your nearest instrument or use your hands, and let's get playing. As always, we're first going to do the rhythmic syllables. Ready, go. Ta-dee-ta, ta-ta, ta-dee-ta, ta. Rest. Ta, ta-dee-ta, ta. Ta-dee-ta, ta. Now let's play and count. Ready, go. One and two, three, four. One and two, three, four. One, two and three, four. One and two, three, four. And finally, let's play and say the letters. G A G F E C D C C. Rest. G F E D D C C D C. Great job, everyone. Remember, make sure you keep that paper in a safe spot so you can reuse it for next week. Last week, I told you guys to record yourselves playing and saying these rhythms and melodies and send them to me in an email. I got a bunch of videos from you guys, and they were all so fun to watch. Each episode, we'll showcase a Falcon friend playing and saying those rhythms and melodies. This week's Falcon friends are Blake Whitman, a third grader at South Lebanon, and Emma Welch, a fourth grader also at South Lebanon. Check them out.
Ready, go.
Great job, Blake and Emma. I especially loved how Emma played the melody on her orchestra bells. To the rest of you, don't forget to keep sending me those videos. You can email them to makingmusicfalconfriends@gmail.com. Remember, I don't know all of you personally, so there's some information that I need you to include in your email. All the directions are listed in the resource folder called Music Reading with Mrs. Dundor. Please go check that out and make sure you have everything you need included in the message of your email before you send it out. Thank you. After the episode, don't forget to check out the links in that same folder. Just 5 minutes a day and you'll be reading music faster than you ever thought you could. All right, that's it for me today. See you next week. Bye, Falcons.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hi, third graders. My name is Mr. Thompson, and I'm the band director at your school. It's time for you to think about joining the band. During episodes of Making Music with Our Falcon Friends, I'm going to show you all the instruments of the band. There are a bunch, so it'll take several weeks for me to show you all of them. Tune in next week to see our first group of instruments. I'm super excited that you might be joining the band soon. See you next week.
This is Mrs. Castle coming to you with your weekly music listening lesson. Just a reminder that any resources that you will need for this week will be in the resources folder under the section titled Listening with Mrs. Castle. For this week's lesson, you will only need the YouTube playlist open and a six-sided dice. First up is the Can-Can, written by a composer named Offenbach. This video is a line rider video, but I want to give you something new to do this week while you're listening. If you open the document called Listen and Roll, it gives you a question for every number on a six-sided dice. Before you click on the link to listen and watch, roll that dice or choose a random number if you don't have a dice, and be specifically focused on that question during your time taking a listen to this piece of music. When you have your question ready to go, click on that first link and enjoy.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
I love a good line rider video. Up next is a song that includes a listening map in the video. This piece is entitled The Young Person's Guide to the Orchestra by Benjamin Britten. The music walks you through the different instrument families in the orchestra in a super fun way. So make sure you're paying attention to when the instruments change because it happens a lot, believe me. Go ahead, click that second link and see how many instruments you can name.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
What a fantastic piece of music. Could you name some of those instruments and their families? Awesome. Well, that's all for this week. See you next week for some more music listening with me, Mrs. Castle.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hello to all third grade students. My name is Dr. Campbell, and I am the string orchestra teacher at your school. I wanted to introduce myself today and to let you know that I will be posting some videos starting next week to demonstrate the instruments in the string family. You will see a violin, a viola, a cello, and a bass. Importantly, you can sign up to learn one of these instruments in fourth grade. Lessons will start in September, so check the music page starting next week for the videos and start thinking about joining orchestra.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hello, thanks for joining me again this week for Music Activities with Mr. Small. Of course, this is going to be based off of Mr. Bridenstine's song that you just learned with him in this episode, Michael Finnegan. Let's sing through that just for a quick review before we get to the activity. There was an old man, ready? There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. The wind came up and blew them in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. All right, now moving on, our activity is to add some additional verses to this. That means the melody is going to sound the same, but the words are going to be different. The second verse to this starts the same, so we can sing, there was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Let's try that. Ready? There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Let's try that again. Ready, sing. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. So that's exactly the same. Now it gets different on the second line, which is, he kicked up an awful din again. He kicked up. Listen to it. He kicked up an awful din again. Let's try that together. Ready, sing. He kicked up an awful din again. Now go back to the beginning. There was an old man. Ready? There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He kicked up an awful din again. Third line to that second verse is, because they said he must not sing again. And it goes, because they said he must not sing again. Let's try that together. Ready, sing. Because they said he must not sing again. All right, go back to the beginning. There was an old man. Here it goes. Ready? Sing. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He kicked up an awful din again because they said he must not sing again. Okay, and the last line to that second verse, poor old Michael Finnegan begin again. Poor old Michael Finnegan begin again. It's the same thing as before, right? Ready, sing. Poor old Michael Finnegan begin again. Let's try that entire new second verse. There was an old man. Ready? There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He kicked up an awful din again because they said he must not sing again. Poor old Michael Finnegan begin again. Great job on that second verse. We're going to do one more new verse on this, and it's the third verse. Starts out the same way, so let's sing it. There was an old man. Ready? There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Now the new part. Ran a race and tried to win again. Ran a race and tried to win again. Let's try that. Ready, go. Ran a race and tried to win again. Let's go back to the beginning. There was an old man. Ready, sing. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Ran a race and tried to win again. Good job keeping up with me. The third line to that, which is also different, got so puffed he had to go in again. Listen again. Got so puffed he had to go in again. And it goes, got so puffed he had to go in again. Let's try that together. Ready, sing. Got so puffed he had to go in again. Let's add that to the rest. There was an old man. Ready, sing. There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. Ran a race and tried to win again. He got so puffed that he had to go in again. And the last part, poor old Michael Finnegan begin again, which is the same as before, okay? So I'm going to sing the whole thing straight through for you one time, and then you're going to try to sing it back with me. It goes, there was an old man named Michael Finnegan, ran a race and tried to win again. Got so puffed he had to go in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan be in again. Let's see if we can do that whole verse together now. Here we go. Ready, sing. There was a man named Michael Finnegan, ran a race and tried to win again. got so puffed he had to go in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. Nice job. And I'm going to play straight through all three of these, but I am not going to sing. I want you to just use your voice along with the song and see if you can remember the words to them all. So here we go from the beginning. I'm just going to play straight through three times. Ready, go, there. If not, rewind and try to do that again on your own with those words as I play the piano. For this week, I have an extra thing for you to go out to test your ears. And it's a channel mixer where it plays some different instruments at the same time, and then it messes with the balance of them. You'll see a little slider go up and then go back down again. And it's to see if your ear can pick up the instrument that is being made a little bit louder than the other ones, and then push back into the mix. And they do that at different levels, and it gets harder and harder and more advanced if you want to choose the more advanced ones as well. So thanks again for joining me this week, and I hope to see you back next week for the next episode. Thank you.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Well, we sure had fun today, didn't we? Hopefully you had as much fun as we did. But it's time to go. So until next time, there's really only one thing left to say.
We'll meet again. I don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just as you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I'm singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
See you next time, guys.
See you next time.
See you next time.
See you next time.